he's now a three-year-old boy. He was almost two at the time. And we left at 1:30 in the morning, and he was awake in his car seat looking out the windows as the fire was coming down on us. It's extremely difficult to put into words. It's literally every emotion you've ever felt aside from happiness. There's disbelief, anger, sadness, frustration, a little bit of, like, you kind of like laugh at like the absurdity of the level of destruction and everything that you've been to. Like, is this really real? Like, who has their house burned down with 1,300 neighbors, right? So our entire purpose from the second we started was to become obsolete. We wanted to be not needed anymore. And so we were like, we're gonna help rebuild, get people back in their homes, and then we're done. It started with a very simple panel discussion with builders, insurance agents, city public officials, that was just meant to be informative. And then it sort of snowballed from there with people wanting more information. And then we got representatives from certain areas of the Coffey Park neighborhood. And it became an official organization. We incorporated, became a nonprofit, with the entire intent being for Coffey Park, by Coffey Park. When you have these individuals where we're able to communicate one-on-one and discuss our feelings, it's important, and it becomes almost this cathartic experience. You don't know how hard it is unless there's someone else that's been through it and can guide you through it. So when we're able to meet these people and say, hey, your fire was a year after ours, or 9 months after ours, and this is where we are, this is what we're doing, this is how you can proceed, it's gonna be okay.